Cette diapo représente
this les slide shows the hydroelectrical resources across the world.
On peut là voir comment les différents pays ou les différentes régions
we can see how the various countries have made use of this free and renewable resource.
The height of the
bar graphs shows the total potential of hydropower production independently from the fact that it may be difficult to build the power plant, of the cost, and also independently of the environmental characteristics which may make it difficult for the power plant to be built. For instance, in Australia, there was very little potential and almost all of it has been used. So we can say now that in Australia, no more hydropower will be produced. In Europe and Northern America, more than half of the potential has been used. Again, it is going to be fairly difficult to use more of the potential. First of all, because economically it wouldn't prove to be profitable, and also it would probably be costly and it might be dangerous for the rivers. Conversely, in South America, there is still a lot of potential left. In Africa, it's unbelievable. In Russia, China, India, there is a lot of potential. Hydropower production across the world is a kind of resource that must be developed. Except that building a hydropower plant is much more expensive than building a thermal power plant, and the states must become aware of the fact that yet it's worthwhile.
Electric
power production across the world is essentially based on thermal power plants. The greenhouse effect gases released by this type of production of burning fossilized fuels is huge. Now, the second world production is based on hydraulic electrical power. Nuclear power has decreased proportionately with the other types of power production. Hydraulic is increasing and all the other renewable energies are going up, plus 16%. Yet there is still a lot of, there are quite a few fossil-fired plants and we really need to make an effort, especially in China. In China, every month a new fossil-fired plant is opened up. The right-hand side graph shows the percentage of hydropower
énergie renouvelable mondiale
in the versus the electrical power production from renewable energies. And here it is the world champion, 78%, wind 12%, biomass, geothermal production and solar much less. We have seen this in the previous slide. A lot can be done across the world to produce more hydropower. In France, power plants producing electricity shows that we have the same share of renewable energies used in France and Germany. The difference is that in France, renewable energies are mainly represented by hydropower, whereas in Germany, they prefer the biomass, also hydraulic and wind, up to a certain extent. Also, it doesn't show on the pie chart. In France, however, we have 75% of nuclear power plants, whereas in Germany, we talk about 75% of coal, gas, and some oil. Let us now look at the consumption curve during a given day, for instance, 6th of January 2015. The curve is a real-time curve. You can actually look it up on the RTE website. RTE stands for Réseau Transport Électricité in France. The curve is updated every 15 minutes. It's quite interesting. In purple, we see the forecast made the previous day,
suivant la courbe,
on January the 4th, it was on January the 5th, it was estimated that at 4 o'clock in the morning, minimum consumption would be approximately 63,000 megawatts, and that, however, at 7 o'clock p.m., maximum consumption would be 81,000 megawatts.
Interestingly,
between 5 and 7 o'clock in the morning, a lot happens because we move from 65,000 megawatts to 80,000 megawatts. So 15,000 megawatts must be found in less than 3 hours. Bear in mind that consumption must match. Production and production must match consumption. At any given time, production must follow consumption. We can't ask people to make a phone call before they switch on their coffee machine. And yet, everybody does that more or less at the same times, and also industrial plants start operating. So hydroelectricity can help mitigate the peak effect. Around 12:30, when the picture was taken, we see that there is a mismatch between estimated production and forecast consumption. This gap between the orange and the purple curve must be cancelled so that production matches the consumption again. And in this case, hydropower production can help solve the problem. How is that achieved? We see a different curve here in volume with all the production means being stacked up. We have compulsory production, run of the river hydropower, for instance, and all the energy that we need to buy, wind, solar, etc., although the values are quite low and not sufficient to meet the consumption peak. Next, we have the big layer, the basis average production, nuclear production, and we have semi-base production, which may vary up to a certain extent. Thermal plants in France, approximately 5% of our electrical power, come from thermal plants burning either diesel oil or coal. And finally, we have in blue the peak production. Turbines can be set in motion very quickly simply by opening or closing the vanes that allow the water flow to reach the turbines, and this peak production allows to follow consumption. When consumption reaches ultra peak levels, we see the two little red layers. STEP are used. STEP are energy transfer pumping plants. Now, this is a very specific type of plant because it uses the technology of hydraulic power plants, but it doesn't need to have a river. Here we have the Rovin power plant in the Ardennes region, 800 megawatts of power, almost the same power as a nuclear power plant, and there is no river. Or hardly. Two reservoirs have been dug, the upper reservoir and the lower reservoir. The two reservoirs are connected. In the mountain, there is a cavern where the pumps and the turbines are located. And when not much electrical power is needed on the grid, the water from the lower basin or reservoir will be pumped up to the upper reservoir. And when all of a sudden there is a peak consumption event and more electrical power is needed, then the water will be allowed to flow from the upper reservoir to the lower reservoir, driving the turbines and producing electrical power. And this can be repeated ad lib, making sure that the water is pumped up to the upper reservoir during low consumption times.